Hi, welcome back to CBSC Board Economics. I'm Sudham Sen. Today we are discussing a very, very important and big topic in Keynesian economics, that's income and employment theory. This is saving function or propensity to save. We have already seen in one of the videos, consumption function or propensity to save. Now let's not mix it up, consumption function with the saving function, though they have very close correlation. Let's concentrate on saving function. Before we go to the saving function or propensity to save, let's get some brief idea about savings. What are saving in the economy? Saving is that part of income which has not been consumed. That part of national income which has not been consumed, we can find out savings by subtracting consumption from the disposable income. S is equal to Y minus C. Suppose income is 100 crores and consumption is 80 crores, savings will be 20 crores. As simple as that. Saving is that part of income that has not been consumed. So we write it here, saving function or propensity, you can see it here. S is equal to function of Y. Mathematically we write saving is equal to function of Y. What it means? Our savings in the economy depends upon our income. That's national income, disposable income. It means if the income is high, savings will also be high. If income is low, savings will also be less. So as simple as that, savings is that part of income which has not been consumed. Our savings in the economy depends upon our income. If income is high, savings will be high. If income is less, savings will be less. So S is equal to function of Y. According to Keynesian psychological theory of consumption, according to Keynes, James Keynes, as income increases, consumption also increases, but it always increases at a lesser rate. Hence, savings will increase at a faster rate. So that's about Keynesian economics. As income increases, consumption also increases, but it always increases at a lesser rate. Hence, savings will increase at a faster rate. That means our savings will depend upon our income. If income is high, savings will be high. If income is low, savings will also be low. As income increases, savings also increases, but that increases at a faster rate, because consumption is increasing at a slower rate. Let's see the saving function we understand here. So we already seen S is equal to Y minus C. Our savings depend upon our Y minus income minus consumption. We have already seen earlier, that is consumption function formula, Y is equal to, we've seen C is equal to C bar plus BY. So Y C, that means at any given level of income, our consumption will be C is equal to C bar plus BY. What exactly this C stands for? C stands for consumption. Our consumption at any given level of income depends upon autonomous consumption C bar. That is, what is autonomous consumption? Autonomous consumption is the consumption at zero level of income. C bar, we write it. We denote it as C bar mathematically. So as we are discussing this big topic, keep concentrating, keep learning the small concepts, because they're likely to come for one mark questions. So don't forget, they can ask you what is C bar. You just have to write one sentence. C bar is autonomous consumption, which is nothing but consumption at zero level of income. And we discussed already, C bar can never be zero. It is always a positive value. There has to be some consumption in the economy, even if the income is zero. C bar is equal to B, C is equal to C bar plus BY. B stands for, we have already learned, B stands for MPC, marginal propensity to consume. That's delta C upon delta Y. And Y stands for income. What this equation means? That means our consumption in the economy at any given level of income is equal to C bar. That is the minimum consumption we require. Plus, as income increases, your consumption also increases B times, that is MPC times. So the slope of the consumption function, is nothing but MPC. The slope of the consumption line is MPC. We'll come to that later. Now we put this equation s is equal to y minus c, we substitute consumption function in this equation s is equal to y minus c bar. We are taking this here minus by here, y minus this consumption function, we put it here, c bar plus by, we expand it here, we open up these brackets, y minus minus c bar minus by. So ultimately the saving function equation, we can write it as here. So s is equal to minus c bar plus 1 minus B. This 1 minus B stands for MPS, marginal propensity to save. Okay, if you don't want to remember this whole equation, just remember this much. S is equal to minus C bar plus 1 minus BY. 1 minus B is nothing but marginal propensity to save. So to explain it further with the help of a table and graph, let's take one small equation, C is equal to C bar plus BY. Here we assume C bar is, C bar is 100 in the economy. That means we need 100 minimum consumption at zero level of income. And MPC we assumed here 0.5. That means whenever the income increases in the economy, the consumption will go up by 50%, 0.5. So we put it in this equation, C is equal to C bar plus BY. C is equal to 100 plus 0.5 y. So similarly, we can write the saving equation here. S is equal to minus C bar plus 1 minus B y. So it becomes minus 100 plus 0.5 y. So we'll take one table here to explain here. See, income, this is income is increasing 0, 100 crores, 200, 300, 400, 500. As income is increasing, consumption also increases according to Keynes. So now at zero level of income, the consumption is 100. How did we get this 100 here? This 100, this we picked up from this equation, this 100 C bar, because at zero level of income, there has to be some consumption, that we call it as autonomous consumption C bar. Then income has gone up from 100, 0 to 100. It has gone up from 100 to 150. How did it gone up to 100 to 150? Because MPC we assumed here as 0.5. It means that whenever the income increases in the economy, the consumption will go up by 50% of that. So that is 100, 150 and 200, it has gone up 150 to 200. Every time income increases by 100, the consumption exactly increases by 50%. So 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, 350. So you can observe here, initially consumption is greater than income. Consumption is greater than income. A stage comes in the economy where income becomes equal to consumption. That, of course, we call it as break-even point. After the break-even point, income is greater than consumption. So remember this, initially consumption is greater than income. A stage comes in the economy when income becomes equal to consumption. That we call it as break-even point. Y is equal to C. After the break-even point, income is greater than consumption. So we derived savings from this here. This will be saving is equal to Y minus C. This is minus 100, minus 50, 0 at the break-even point. Then 50, 100, 150. This delta C change in consumption is 50-50 constantly because of this equation MPC is 0.5. And delta S is also 50-50, it's going up because MPS is also 0.5. So obviously keep one thing in mind, the value of MPC plus MPS is equal to 1. Delta C, delta S are equal here. So APC, C upon Y, which we learned it earlier, as income increases, APC is declining here, 1.5, 1.9, 0.7, 0.6. What does it indicate? As income increases, consumption also increasing, but it always increases at a lesser rate. That's what Keynes said. And now we found out APS S upon Y, the APS 0.5, 0, 0.1, 0.3 is increasing. APS because consumption increases at a lesser rate and savings increases at a faster rate, APS is increasing. Because APC plus APS you can find out from that is equal to 1. MPC and MPS are 0.1, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 because they are constant here. That's given in the equation. Now let's understand here. So 2-3 points clear here. Income in the economy can be zero, but consumption can never be zero. The consumption at zero level of income is called autonomous consumption. Second point, initially consumption is greater than income. Then at the break-even point, income is equal to consumption. That we call it as break-even point. At the break-even point, savings will be zero. After the break-even point, income is greater than consumption. So now we derive the saving function from the consumption function here. So look here carefully. On the x-axis, we got income. On the y-axis, you got consumption here. This is the guiding line, 45 degrees line. We call it as income line. On this line, y is equal to c plus s. Any point on this line is a break-even point. The consumption line, a consumption function, always starts from above zero because consumption can never be zero. This point, this we call it as, this is the autonomous consumption, c bar. Now, as income is increasing here, you can see it here, consumption is also increasing. You can see it here, increasing, right? And initially, consumption curve, a consumption function is above the income line. Hence, the savings are negative here. C is greater than Y. A stage comes, both consumption line and income line intersect. That we call it as a break-even point. After the break-even point, income line is above consumption. Savings are positive. And now the saving curve we derive from the consumption curve. Look at this one. When there is C bar in the economy, the savings are here maybe 100. This is minus 100. The keep one thing in mind, the saving curve always starts below the zero axis or x axis because of negative savings. Here savings are positive C bar. This we write it as minus C bar. So first point, remember, this starts from the positive range of the y-axis. This starts from the negative range, having equal distance almost. This is 100 minus this plus 100. This minus 100. As long as consumption is greater than income, we learned savings are negative. Hence, saving curve is below the y-axis. Savings. Then a stage comes in the economy at the break-even point, so y is equal to c. At this point, savings are zero, hence saving curve is intersecting the OX-axis. That is zero here, savings are intersecting OX-axis here, savings are zero. This also we can call it as a break-even point. After the break-even point, hence income is greater than consumption, savings are positive, savings line will be above the x-axis. At times they can ask you derive the saving curve from consumption function or consumption curve. Remember the 4 points. The first point is when the income is zero, consumption is C bar, autonomous consumption. Hence the consumption line, consumption curve, consumption function starts above the zero axis. Hence the savings are minus zero. The saving curve starts in the negative range of the OY axis. Second point. As long as the consumption is greater than income, savings are negative, hence the saving curve is below the x-axis. By dragging this line, you are slowly getting the saving function, saving curve. At the break-even point, y is equal to c, consumption line intersects the income line. At the break-even point, savings are zero, hence the saving line is intersecting the y-axis. After the break-even point, income is greater than consumption line, hence the saving or positive saving line is above the income line. I'm sure you must have followed this, though it's a big one. So derivation of saving curve from consumption curve, say consumption function. So consumption function, saving function, they are closely related. Consumption function and saving function, propensity to consume and propensity to save, they're closely related. Okay, so that's all. We have time. Go through this carefully. Goodbye.